they thought was their success and what they thought was their fare. Check their social media. It's important to know who you're going to be bringing into the office. Let your candidate know about the process that's going to happen with the interview. When will it be? Where will it be? Who else is going to be involved in the interview process? You don't want your potential employee to be caught off guard and then overwhelmed by the situation that they're in. So it's important to like tie up all those loose ends, that way they know what they're doing. So conduct an interview in a comfortable setting. I'm not saying let them put their feet up somewhere, but don't provide an environment where they're comfortable to talk in, and that will allow the flow of the conversation to go and have more open dialect. If it's in your office, clean your desk, turn off your silent your calls, that way they're more comfortable. If you have just one interview, it's not a big deal, but if you have multiple interviews, you should have a schedule planned. That way, there's no overlaps with people. So whether you want to have time select for each subject or time limit in general, that's up to you, but have a schedule, that way you avoid that mess. Now, you have your job description up to date, and you know what you're gonna you know what you're looking for, and you have an idea what your candidate's gonna be. So make the most of the time with your candidate and ask the right questions. As Gino mentioned, there's behavioral, stress, structured. These questions allow you to get more info that you need to know about your candidate. Follow-up questions are the best way to get a real good glimpse into your potential candidate. By asking them to provide more information on their response, you're gonna get a more human answer and not the robot one that they had planned out. This helps you get to know the candidate better and will help you get more insight on them. No one likes one-word answers and thoughtless responses, so as an employer, you shouldn't provide anything less than what you would expect from your future employee. As a great candidate and a smart one is going to ask you questions, so be prepared for that and make sure that they want to work for this company. This is probably really obvious, but there's questions you can't ask. Don't ask about their age, their weight, children, gender, national origin, or anything that will get you sued, because if EEOC takes up the case, you guys are gonna be screwed, so it's best that you just avoid that all entirely. Doing the interview gives you a little bit of power, but don't let it go into your head. You want the candidate to be comfortable, so smile, lean forward, act engaged, even if you're not. And remember to treat this almost like a conversation and not an interrogation. You want them to feel at ease so they'll open up more and you'll get that info that you're looking for. Now, I don't know about you guys, but if I don't write it down, I'm going to forget it pretty much immediately. So don't be aggressive about it, but take notes. That way you have something to look back on and you can compare candidates against each other. It's also important to take notes so you don't get them mixed up later when you're just trying to decide who you want to pick. It's good to ask specific questions that match each criteria for what you're looking for, but don't let it end there. Use the whole interview to evaluate each factor that will get you a more well-rounded idea about your candidate and their fit for the position in the company. So I said answer questions thoroughly, but don't take over the whole interview. Your candidates need to do most of the talking because that's how you get what you need. It's better to understand them and their reasoning for wanting to be in the company in the first place. So keep your answers short and sweet. At the conclusion of the interview, let their interviewee know what's going on. Let them know if you have more interviews and when you're going to be contacting them next. If a second interview is to be scheduled, give them details about that. This just helps tie up the loose ends of the conversation and keep your potential employee in contact. Once the interview is over and you said your goodbyes, ask around and see how the candidate acted before and after the interview. The best place would probably be the front desk, because that's where they probably were first and were last contact with. How do they act? What were they doing? This might give you insight on how they'll act on the job. So for my new and you, I currently work at ATC Healthcare Services, or intern there, which is a staffing agency located in Upper Darby. As a recruiting firm, we do a lot of interviews and we do a lot of research before we contact a candidate, because it's medical field's like a life and death situation for a lot, and credentials are taken very seriously. The franchise president of ATC is Sean Murphy, and he conducts interviews in a very comfortable and open manner. When I first got contacted, For the position, he explained the whole job description on phone in detail, and he did this so that way I'd know if I wanted to drive all the way there. The interview itself was comfortable and easygoing. He described the job all over again and allowed me to ask any questions that I needed. He's very detailed, but he's short, and that's how he conducts most of his interviews. So right now I'm just learning the basics, but hopefully I'll be learning how to, I'll be doing interviewing later on. So recap, know the position you're hiring for or what candidate you're looking for. Keep things comfortable in order to get the interview flowing and the conversation going. Always use follow-up questions and don't ask the dumb ones. Just remember to take notes and realize that the interview feeds off you, so it's important that you do your best to be nice. So next up is Andre, and he's doing the structured interview.
We've already talked about structured interviews briefly. Gino covered just a little bit, so I'm going to be coming at it from a different perspective. This is from the point of view of the interviewer, how to conduct a structured interview, if you will. Okay. Procedure is very important in a structured interview. You absolutely need to know beforehand what questions you're going to ask and in what order you're going to ask them. You also need to know what you're going to be looking for when you ask those questions. It's also important that you use the same set of questions for everyone that you're interviewing. I've got a little hint or a cheat sheet here, how to, you know, teach yourself how to put your interviewing process together. You definitely want to practice or at least have yourself a dry run before you go through your interviewing questions. And that's because you want to avoid errors. You want to avoid errors of judgment. The most common ones, I think, are first impressions or stereotypes. If you find yourself in a situation where you've already got a preconceived notion of an interviewer and you haven't even said hello, you definitely want to take a step back, because the margin of error is way too high and you'll definitely miss the good candidate that you're looking for. In those cases, you also open up your firm or your company to legal challenges. And so you definitely want to mitigate those losses for your company as well. Standardization, we're back on this subject. You definitely want every question to be absolutely the same. And that's because if you don't, coming from a science background, if you don't do the same steps for each experiment, you will introduce an independent variable that you didn't want originally. If you don't get that reference, you definitely some of you didn't get the reference. You want your questions in the interview to stay on topic. You absolutely want, if you're asking a job-related question, you want to name the job and find out exactly what it is that they would do in that job. And what you're looking for is what they have done or what they will do. You want to focus on their behavior. Past behavior is an indicator of future behavior. And so once you get a sense of what to do, you can start ask what they'll do. You'll start asking situational questions. Situational questions are hypothetical situations that you set up beforehand, and you just ask them because you want to figure out what they're going to do. Keep in mind that with your situational questions, you're not necessarily getting the truth. Every candidate has been taught from day one that they are supposed to answer from the point of view of the best possible candidate for a job. And so what you get is largely going to be a fabrication, but that's not what you're looking for. You're looking for how they arrived at their answer. Back on behavioral questions, another note. When asking behavioral questions, there are a couple of things that you do want to ascertain for yourself, and that's just in your notes, things that you want to retain so that you can make a proper decision later on. Those three things are, you want to get the details of a situation. For example, you ask them, when was a time where you conducted an experiment or a time where you put together an event, and you want to know the details of the event, you want to know what actions they took in response to the challenge of having to do it, and you also want to figure out if whether or not they achieved the result that they want. When you're asking job knowledge questions, that should be cut and dry. You actually want to describe a process, for example, for a mechanic, go through the process of changing a tire verbally, and they'll have to actually do that. There are a lot of times where you don't want your questions to be very technical, or you'll get a response and you're not gonna like it. So you wanna keep the job-related questions to the level of a person that you expect to have entering the job, not one who has that experience already. So to recap, you want your behavioral questions to actually focus on the behaviors that will be relevant to the job. You want your situational questions to measure how the candidate gets to the answer or the result. And you want, oh, I'm sorry, I missed my cue there. Also, you want, as Stephanie mentioned, you want to be able to discuss what exactly they will be doing on a day-to-day basis for the job. They'll want to know what their responsibilities are and what the critical components of the job are, and you want that before you actually get out of the interview. This is yet another reference. For those that don't know, this is a Rowan tree. I did my internship at Rowan at the OCA, where I was a career advisor, and I conducted structured interviews. The strongest part of my duty was the mock interview. And I want to say that all of my mock interviews were in the structured format. I always had predetermined questions, and I always asked people basically the same questions. You do have to tailor it to what their actual major is. Apparently I did such a good job that they offered me a paid position, and so in the future you can find me at the OCA and you can have a mock interview if you want to. My office hours are not posted yet.
Oh, you're done?